Hello, it's Mr. Schneider again. This is podcast 2.5, part 1, strategies to evaluate campaign speeches, literature, and advertisements for accuracy. So the first thing you have to be able to do is to be able to separate fact from opinion. Do you know what a fact is? Do you know what an opinion is? When you're watching somebody talk politically, are what they're saying is a fact? Washington, D.C. is the capital of the United States. Or is it opinion? I really don't like the president. Let's see. Imagine, pray that you know what a fact, what the difference between a fact and opinion before that video. But when you're watching political advertising, you know, make sure that you realize what's fact and what's opinion, what can be proven and what cannot be proven. All right. Make sure you're able to detect bias. What is the candidate trying to get you to believe? And more importantly, what viewpoint is it coming from? Who's putting on that ad?
Jefferson, Abraham Lincoln. What do these men have in common? Marty Huggins has read about these leaders and said, I can do better. He's a visionary.
Let's get rid of daylight savings time, right? Because I hate when it gets dark early.
A family man. And he's multicultural.
I'm glad to be here. It's the first time I've worn a Yamaha.
Why vote for Marty Huggins? He's a small-town dreamer with big-town ideas on how to take Washington by storm.
Washington, D.C. is a mess.
A mess like his opponent, Cam Brady. Another Washington fat cat who only knows one word.
I can't.
Can't's the real C word.
Isn't it time to give Washington a Huggins?
Get out your vacuums, your dust mops, your glass plus, your bleaches, your Brasso, Wade air fresheners. Things are a mess. It's a mess.
I'm Marty Huggins, and I approve this message.
Thank you very much. Vote Marty Huggins, paid for by Americans United in Unity.
How's that?
Clean up Washington with Marty at
Obviously an ad for Marty Huggins going against his opponent there. All right. You should be able to evaluate sources. Who made and is distributing this material? Where is it coming from? So let's go ahead.
They served their country with courage and distinction. They're the men who served with John Kerry in Vietnam. They're his entire chain of command. Most of the officers in Kerry's unit. Even the gunner from his own boat. And they're the men who spent years in North Vietnamese prison camps, tortured for refusing to confess what John Kerry accused them of being war criminals. They were also decorated, many very highly, They are teachers, farmers, businessmen, ministers, and community leaders. And of course, fathers and grandfathers, with nothing to gain for themselves except the satisfaction that comes with telling the truth. They have come forward to talk about the John Kerry they know, because to them, honesty and character still matter, especially in a time of war. Swift Vets and POWs for Truth are responsible for the content of this advertisement.
So if you look at the end of this,
On Kerry, they know, because to them, honesty and character still matter, especially in a time of war. Swift Vet.
All right, so you can look at this ad and you could say, oh, that's not, that wasn't put on by John Kerry's opponent, but you could also look and say that that ad is obviously going against John Kerry. So I'm sure that President Bush wasn't upset this ad was running. Okay? All right, I'm back. So let's look at different types of propaganda. And there's seven we have here. We're going to look at ads for all seven of them. First one is testimonial.
We endorse Barack Obama for the president. That still sticks, right?
Yeah, of course.
Can a black man be elected president of the United States?
I believe he can. I believe a black man can, and I believe he can.
You think he's going to win the nomination?
I'm not here to say whether he will win or not, but I believe you asked me, do I believe he can? I believe that he can. Is it possible? Yes, I do believe that it's possible. This is my senator, my favorite senator.
All right, so that was testimonial. Oprah was giving testimony saying that she believes Barack Obama is the best candidate. Next one is bandwagon. So everybody's voting for Ike, so you should vote for Ike. Let's see here, let's go back. All right. Plain folks.
It's morning again in America. Today, more men and women will go to work than ever before in our country's history. With interest rates and inflation down, more people are buying new homes, and our new families can have confidence in the future. America today is prouder and stronger.
All these people are doing better. Ronald Reagan's just the plain folk like you and me. Everybody's doing better. All right, name calling.
Newt Gingrich was a career politician selling access here in Washington, D.C.
The year that he ran for Congress in 1978, he made a grand total of $10,000. By the time he became the Speaker, he made $675,000. By the time he left Congress, he's brought his net worth up to about $7.5 million.
84 ethics complaints while he was Speaker, driven out of the Speakership in disgrace.
Having to pay $300,000 for lying, for complete fraud.
And I have lots of things to do, maybe earn a little bit of money.
Newt Gingrich is also the latest example of how the corrupt revolving door drives Washington.
Paid $100 million playing the revolving door game.
A big part of that is just lobbying money.
Congress is really bought and sold. They're bought and sold legally.
If you've been Speaker of the House, you're always an insider.
Gingrich received up to $1.8 million from Freddie Mac just before it collapsed. His think tank's got $37 million from the healthcare industry.
Newt Gingrich renewed his support for an individual mandate, a key tenet of President Obama's healthcare law.
Newt Gingrich has been on both sides of a long list of issues.
He went the other way when he got paid to go the other way.
Do you think voters are going to, like, warm up to you because you're boasting about getting $60,000 a speech?
I was charging $60,000 a speech. Normally celebrities leave and they gradually sell fewer speeches every year. We were selling more.
He is the absolute symbol of that corrupt system.
Newt Gingrich. This guy hasn't got skeletons in his closets. He's got a whole graveyard in there.
It's about serial hypocrisy.
All right, so you saw all those negative things, serial hypocrisy, graveyards in his closet, ethics complaints. That's name-calling. All right. Let's go to transfer. All right, so President Reagan, your love of the army and the flag and the Statue of Liberty, you're transferring those feelings from the president, or from those things, to President Reagan. Glittering generality.
An economic meltdown.
Worst financial collapse since the Great Depression.
4.4 million jobs lost.
American workers were laid off in numbers not seen in over three decades.
America's economy spiraling down.
The biggest point drop that has ever been seen in a day.
All before this president took the oath.
So help me God.
Some said our best days were behind us, but not him.
Don't bet against the American worker.
He believed in us, fought for us. And today, our auto industry is back, firing on all cylinders. Our greatest enemy brought to justice by our greatest heroes. Our troops are home from Iraq. Instead of losing jobs, we're creating them. Over 4.2 million so far. We're not there yet. It's still too hard for too many. But we're coming back because America's greatness comes from a strong middle class. Because you don't quit, and neither does he.
All right, so generalities, creating jobs, coming back, don't quit, we believed. All right, and then our last one is card stacking.
The original Mavericks. He fights pork barrel spending. She stopped the bridge to nowhere. He took on the drug industry. She took on big oil. He battled Republicans and reformed Washington. She battled Republicans and reformed Alaska. They'll make history. They'll change Washington. McCain Palin. Real change.
I'm John McCain and I approve this message.
All right, so card stacking. You know, we did this and this and this and this and this and this. And here's statistics to prove it. And here's articles to prove it. This is what we did. So you're stacking all these things you did. All right, so that is campaign material, and that's podcast 2.5 part 1. Thanks, guys. Bye.